The maiden mission to Mars. This is what Musk has indicated will happen as early as next year. However, a pressing question remains. How can this be achieved when Starship still has many outstanding objectives? It's important to remember that SpaceX has detailed a strategy for 25 launches scheduled for next year from Starbase. Furthermore, it's highly likely they have designed a specific trajectory to Mars as part of that strategy. So, what will SpaceX's journey to Mars look like in the coming year? And what additional arrangements still need to be finalized? Let's discuss it all in today's episode of NR Studio. Musk has once again shocked the space exploration community with a bold announcement. The maiden mission to Mars could be closer than anticipated. Musk claims that the mission, which includes the Optimus payload, is guaranteed to happen within 3.5 years. However, he also admitted that there is a small but significant possibility that this pioneering mission could happen as early as the end of next year. This idea alone has captivated space enthusiasts worldwide. However, it raises an important question. How can SpaceX realistically achieve this when Starship still faces so many obstacles? Musk himself has acknowledged that many factors must align for this to happen. His assessment is accurate. Currently, Starship has not achieved orbital flight, has not launched a primary payload, has not fully perfected two-stage recovery, and has not yet built or tested the complex orbital refueling system. All of these milestones are not only desirable, but also crucial to a Mars mission. All must be achieved within the short timeframe of next year if Musk's ambitious aspirations are to be realized. However, despite how improbable it may seem, there is a strategy. SpaceX has announced plans to launch up to 25 missions annually from Starbase beginning in 2026. This level of operational activity is unprecedented in the aerospace sector. If realized, it would facilitate rapid iteration, frequent assessments, and the ability to achieve these critical milestones in rapid succession. Indeed, leaked information and internal schedules have suggested how these 25 missions might develop. Combined, they would provide a viable roadmap to Mars. Let's explore what this plan might entail. Flight 11 is expected to be very similar to Flight 10. It will serve as a conclusive Gen 2 assessment before SpaceX moves on to the highly anticipated Version 3 equipment. This brings us to Flight 12, which is expected to be the inaugural V3 mission. SpaceX sources indicate that this flight will not be intended for orbital insertion, but will instead focus on evaluating the significant improvements included in the new version. Initially, SpaceX intended to conduct Flight 12 prior to the conclusion of this year, but due to the sluggish advancement of both the launch vehicles and the ground infrastructure, it is becoming more probable that Flight 12 will be postponed to the following year. Consequently, either Flight 12 or Flight 13 will essentially signify the onset of the ambitious 25-flight initiative in 2026. Musk has indicated that one of the immediate focuses is to successfully catch both stages, which paves the way for Flights 13 through 15. Flight 13 could potentially be a crucial operation where SpaceX tries to capture both the booster and the spacecraft. For this objective to be achieved, Starship needs to first prove its capability to attain orbit. Hence, the importance of this mission cannot be overstated. If it succeeds, Flight 14 may concentrate solely on enhancing the recovery procedure, whereas Flight 15 could signify the inaugural deployment of a payload into orbit. By that time, three significant achievements would be realized: reaching orbit, ensuring reusability through stage recovery, and deploying payloads into orbit. Once these essential milestones are achieved, SpaceX would be poised to focus on the most complex aspect, which is the development and validation of the orbital refueling system. The initial refueling trials could potentially take place as early as Flight 16 and 17. In these missions, SpaceX would launch two Starships, one functioning as the target and the other as the pursuing vessel. They would aim to connect in orbit and transfer fuel, thereby marking the very first instance of such an operation being attempted. This would represent a groundbreaking achievement not just for SpaceX, but for the broader field of space exploration. If the docking and fuel transfer are successful, the subsequent logical step would involve establishing an orbital fuel depot during Flight 18. The depot would serve as a storage facility in low Earth orbit, prepared to provide fuel for Starships heading to Mars. Since each Starship requires around 1,600 tons of propellant and can only transport about 100 tons in a single launch, it would necessitate approximately 16 tanker flights to completely fill the depot. This implies that flights 19 through 34 could be almost entirely allocated to tanker operations. Once the depot is fully stocked and Starship is prepared, Flight 35 would ultimately make the groundbreaking journey to Mars. Starship would dock with the depot, load up on its complete propellant supply, and embark on the extended journey to the Red Planet. Following this plan, SpaceX would need a total of 23 missions from Flight 13 to Flight 35 to finalize the complete process of preparing for Mars. Even if Flight 12 is delayed until next year, there would still be 24 out of the 25 scheduled missions available, providing them with one additional flight as a buffer. However, there remains the possibility of expediting the schedule if SpaceX adopts a more adventurous approach. For instance, should SpaceX manage to capture both stages in Flight 13 while also achieving orbit, they could consolidate several milestones within a single mission.
This would lead to an advancement of the timeline by one flight for all operations. In that case, payload deployment could take place on the 14th flight. Demonstrations for refueling could be done on flights 15 and 16. The depot might launch on the 17th. Tankers would operate from the 18th to the 33rd flight, and the Mars expedition could be conducted during flight 34. This rendition of the plan would necessitate only 22 flights, starting from 13, or 23 flights in total if flight 12 is postponed to the following year. In simpler terms, it could create two available extra missions within the 25-flight timeline. In both scenarios, calculations indicate that, theoretically, SpaceX could gear up for a Mars mission within the boundaries of 25 launches. If they maintain a launch rate of 2 to 3 per month, it may indeed be feasible to reach Mars by the end of next year. This would require impeccable execution, swift adaptation, and nearly flawless outcomes. Nevertheless, it is not an impossible dream, particularly considering SpaceX's history of accomplishing what many once deemed unattainable. However, the actual situation is seldom as straightforward as a theoretical plan. Delays, failures, and unforeseen obstacles will likely arise. Musk's ambitious timelines are not solely about the goals themselves. They aim to motivate his teams and the broader space sector to accelerate, embrace challenges, and innovate at a speed that keeps humanity at the forefront. So, what are your thoughts? Is it really possible for SpaceX to execute this bold vision and launch Starship to Mars as soon as next year? Share your opinions with a yes or no in the comments, and feel free to add your insights. Additionally, remember to like the video and subscribe to our channel to stay informed about this remarkable journey of humanity's first steps towards becoming a multiplanetary species.